Hi everyone, I'm Peter Wolf with Azamba Consulting Group, and today we're going to talk about integrating Sage 100 with Sage CRM. Before we get started, who is Azamba Consulting Group? Since 2007, we've helped over 400 small and medium-sized companies get up and running successfully with Sage CRM. Most of those are integrated with the Sage accounting system, either Sage 100, Sage 300, or Sage X3. So we really know what we're talking about when it comes to the accounting integrated version of CRM. We focus on quick deployments. We've won multiple awards from Sage over the years. Our real focus, though, our real differentiator is we do everything with 100% money back guarantee. That way you know that we have the same goals that you do, which is your success. For today's agenda, we're going to talk about the benefits of Sage 100 integration with Sage CRM. We're going to talk about the different integration options, and then we're going to do a demo. I'm going to show you how to do quotes and orders for your prospects and your customers, how to convert a prospect to a customer, and how to do lookups for customers. So things like, what did they buy last month? What are their outstanding invoices, credit limits, things like that. When we talk about the integration benefits between Sage 100 and Sage CRM, there's really four key things that I like to talk about. And before we get into that, if you're watching this, you don't have Sage CRM yet, you don't have an integrated accounting system, you're probably facing a scenario that's very common, which is you're using Sage 100 for prospecting and selling, you're using emails, you're using spreadsheet, you're using some combination of those things to kind of manage your day. So there's different information in different silos throughout your company, and it creates inefficiencies. And you probably are already feeling it, but as you go through the demo today, you'll see I'll give you some examples of the efficiency gains that you get from bringing it all together in one place. But to sum it up, in essence, people that need to be in a sales tool to manage follow-ups and reminders and, you know, process flows to control the way they deal with customers and prospects, they can be in that tool that is most suited for them, CRM, but still have access to the accounting data. That enables number two, which is faster customer responses. Having everything in one place versus having to go to different people or different systems, by having it all in one place, you can respond faster to customer inquiries and prospect inquiries to ensure they stick around, ensure that you don't miss a trick and that you close that business. The third benefit is greater flexibility. Again, having everything in one place allows you to mobilize the way you want to around sales instead of being in the accounting system, which by nature is rigid. It's designed for controls and audit trails. CRM is designed for sales motions, which needs to be a little bit more flexible. So you can have dynamic conditions. So for example, if it's this type of sale, do these things. If it's this type of sale, do these other things. So that's the power of CRM, but combine it with the accounting information to help you move along your day. And then the fourth thing is you can lower your costs. So if you have Sage 100 licenses for all your salespeople, you will no longer need to have those with the Sage 100 Sage CRM integration, because the Sage CRM will give you everything that you need and people will not need to go over to the accounting system anymore. So you can let go of those licenses and instead get Sage CRM licenses, which are, generally speaking, much more affordable. A little bit about the integration. There's three main options. The first option is the one that we recommend for most customers. It may not fit for you. And what I'd like to do is, if you want to talk more about your specific scenario, definitely reach out to us at azamba.com/sage. There's a place there to set up an appointment with me to talk about your particular situation, and there'll be more resources for you. But generally speaking, the out-of-the-box integration is the one we recommend. It lowers your total cost of ownership. You have one throat to choke, if you will. Everything is Sage. You got the Sage accounting, Sage CRM, and you got the integration by Sage. So that makes things very effective. Where the Sage out-of-the-box integration doesn't work so well is if you have remote salespeople who need to do quotes and orders from their phones. So the out-of-the-box integration doesn't always work in those cases, but you've got two other options, which is the Azamba ERP toolbox. That's a set of tools, screens that we've built for our customers to help them. It basically enables access to information through the web. And then there's the Graytrix third-party Gumu integration, which is a third-party integration that does everything through the web as well. Now, I'm gonna leave off there and just say that I'll have other videos for those two situations, but today I'm gonna focus on the out-of-the-box integration. And like I said before, if you're not sure, just reach out to me and we can go through your particular situation. So With that said, I'd like to move on to the presentation. Okay, we're in our Sage CRM system now, and let's do something common that everyone has to do, which is quote your prospects. Now, if you are using Sage 100 right now for sales, you probably have a prospect set up as customers in the AR customer file, and you do your quotes right from there. A more natural fit, though, is with CRM, is to use CRM for prospecting, and then once that customer has been qualified to the point where they actually want to buy, then you'll promote them to being a customer. And if you already are using Sage 100 for quoting prospects, don't worry about that. As part of our process, if you do decide to go forward, we'll help you make sure that all the data gets to the right spots. But for now, let's just go ahead and do a quote for this prospect. So I've got a prospect design right. So I'll quickly find them through my search function. And I can see in here, I've pulled up design right, they're a prospect. And now I want to put a quote together for them. And so as a salesperson or an inside sales or CSR, whoever it is that does your quotes, you would probably normally go right to Sage 100 right now. But what I'm going to do is just pull up this menu here, and I can see I can do either quotes or orders right here from the prospect screen. And I'm going to jump in and do a quote. And when I do, the first thing it's going to do is just confirm I want to pull up the Sage 100 accounting software, which I do. And it's going to go ahead and just give me a confirmation box. So what this is doing here is just making sure I'm on the right record. You don't want to have any mistakes. And it's also going to allow me to attach the quote to an existing opportunity. Now, in brief, if mostly what you do is quote people, the simple example of what an opportunity is I like to use the example of a car dealership. So in a car dealership, if I ran a car dealership and you came in to buy a car, I'd have a chance to sell you a car. That'd be an opportunity. Now, you may look at the Ferrari, you may look at the Lamborghini. I'm not sure what your tastes are. You might even look at a Honda, I don't know. But you'll go ahead and I'll give you quotes on each of those cars. But really there's only one opportunity, which is to sell a car. You're not gonna buy all three cars. At least I don't think you are. So that's kind of what an opportunity is. It's a bucket to store multiple quotes in. A lot of times though, if you just do one quote per opportunity, and really that quote is the opportunity, then you just do this, you hit this auto assign. I'm gonna hit proceed here. And what it does is it pulls up my Sage 100 screen. So for many of you, this will look very familiar. So this is my Sage 100 screen. And just like making a quote normally in Sage 100, I would come here, I would pick my items. It works exactly like your Sage 100 screen. And I'm not gonna dive into all the details here, except to just say that this works exactly like you'd expect. And what happens is once you've saved this quote, it will put it into the Sage 100 system, but it's also going to put it into the Sage CRM system. So at any point, I'm gonna cancel this and just go ahead and pull up one that I've already done. But so this is a quote that I've already done for this prospect. And at any point I can come in here, I can look at these quotes and I could pull it up and I can see I quoted them some product here, the totals, who it's going to be shipped to, etc. And then if I ever needed to convert this, I could go ahead and convert this. So it works really cleanly, really seamlessly, and it's all done from right within Sage CRM. A key thing to note though is if this is a prospect and they want to buy, you're going to want to convert them to a customer first. So you'll go back over to their customer record and there's this little button here that says maintain relationship. So this does exactly what you would hope it would do. I would want to promote them to a customer. I would click this and it's going to again confirm that I'm going into Sage 100 and I'm going to be able to choose an existing customer. So if you've already set them up inside of accounting, you'll be able to connect them, or you'll be able to auto assign. You'll be able to pick a template, so it'll set up the terms code, pay, you know, defaults, credit limits, things like that. I generally recommend that you have this function be done by an accounting person, just to make sure that there's that discipline there to run a credit check and make sure that they get set up properly with payment terms. Most of our customers will disable this function for the actual salespeople, and instead it will be a request promotion to customer. And so you'll push that button, it'll email someone in the accounting department to come in here and promote them to a customer. But the nice thing is once it's been promoted, this prospect will then say customer, and then they're going to be linked. And once they're linked, you're going to see an inquiry tab show up that's going to allow you to look at other accounting documents. And it'll show up right here between documents and this ERP toolbox. And I'm going to show you that in a second. This is my sample database, so I'd rather not change the data. I'm actually just going to go pull up an actual customer that's already in our system. So I'm going to look for American Business Futures. There they are. And when I pull them up, I can see that they are a customer. And I don't know if you noticed, but this information showed up down here. So there's all sorts of customer details about them. And if I go over to this inquiries tab, which also just showed up, I can see additional information as well. So I can pull up customer inquiry. And what this does is it pulls up the Sage 100 customer inquiry screen. So I can see all sorts of details. So as a sales rep, I can see if they're on credit hold, what their credit limit is. I can see age receivable. So if they owe us a lot of money and how late that is, I can go and look at outstanding invoices, payments. I can see sales orders. A very common thing that happens is a customer calls up and says, you know, what's going on with order number 153? So I can come in here and just pull that order up. And I can go over the line items and I can see, oh, well, this hasn't been shipped yet because some of the items are in back order. Our policy is not to ship until everything is in. Do you want me to do a partial shipment? And so I can quickly help that customer out and get them on their way. It's a huge advantage. I don't need to put them on hold. I don't need to go connect with my accounting department. I can just get them on their way and help them out and satisfy their requests at any time. So that's essentially what you can do with this screen. And this works exactly as you'd imagine. This is exactly the Sage 100 customer inquiry screen. So anything that you do over there, you can do in here. There's some other reports here. So these are really just different ways to look at the customer inquiry data, but you can see sales orders, invoices, open RMAs, etc. So you've got a real breadth and depth of information that you could pull up as a CRM user. So this gives the access to the accounting data to all your people that use CRM for all the functions that CRM are used for. So in here, this is the natural place where I track follow-ups, phone calls. If a customer does call inquiring about a back order, I can record a phone call about that, just make sure that we're all aware that that customer was not happy. So we can start to track those kind of metrics as well. So that's the basics of how the Sage 100 and Sage CRM integration work. Just some quick notes here though. Some of these screens where they pop up the Sage 100 screen, you need to understand that this is actually pulling up the Sage 100 screen. And this is a Windows-based screen. So one of the common questions we get is, will this work for my remote salespeople or on my phones? The short answer is it will not work. It will not pull anything that's this Windows-based screen will not pull up over your phone. It can't run on Android or iOS device. What you can do is you can either do it on a Windows laptop using a VPN where it would pull up the screens on the remote network, or you can look at the advanced integration from Graytrix. And we'll have a video on our website for that, so you can take a look at that. But if you have any questions about how that works, those are two other options. The other thing that we've done is we've helped our customers with this program called the ERP Toolbox. So we've replicated a lot of the forms with web-based forms, and that way you can see sales orders, invoices, products purchased, top 10 products of your customers without having to pop up a Sage 100 screen. So there are some different ways around that. And if you want more information, please give me a call. It's important to note that for most of the customers, and we've helped a lot of customers with this, 90% of them, the out-of-the-box functionality is perfectly fine. But if it's not fine for you, don't worry about that because we can help you with one of those other options that'll get you on your way successfully. Okay, well, thank you for your time today, and I'm sure you have plenty of questions. Check out the link at www.azamba.com/sage, and there'll be more resources for you. And there's a form to do a free assessment and to connect with me for a personal one-on-one conversation. Okay, thank you very much. Bye.